Hey everybody, and welcome to our very first tutorial in the Introduction to Computer Art series. Today we're going to explore Adobe Photoshop, a powerful tool used by artists and designers worldwide. Here in this video, we'll start with the basics, understanding the interface, workspace, panels, and basic navigation. So let's get started by opening Adobe Photoshop. When you open Adobe Photoshop, you'll see a variety of tools and panels. Listen, don't worry if this seems overwhelming at first. We're going to go through each of them step by step. On the left, we have the Tools panel. This is where you're going to find the tools for editing and creating images. At the top, when you select any of the specific tools, you're going to notice you have an options bar. These display the options for the currently selected tool. On the right-hand side of your screen, you're going to have different panels. These panels could be anything from layers to adjustments to the history panel, you name it. If you don't see a specific panel, you can navigate to the window icon at the top of the screen. There, you'll find all of the different panels that are available for you in Adobe Photoshop. Now, one of the things that I want to make sure that you do is we are all sharing the same workspace. So I'm going to go to Window Workspace, and I encourage all of you to set it to Essentials Default and then Reset Essentials. What this essentially will do is reset all of those different panels, so you should have the same panels that I have on my screen on yours. All right, now that we have the basic interface underway, let's go ahead and open a photo in Photoshop. You can do this a few different ways. One way is you could drag and drop your file into the Photoshop workspace. Another more common way is to go to File, and we'll go to the Open key, and then we're going to select the area in which our computer houses that specific file. So I'm going to choose balloons and the stock image, which I'll provide in the link below, and we'll double click and open that file. So once we have a file open, you can see that our workspace is filled with this particular image. You also may notice that we have our very first layer in the layers panel. Now this layer is really, really important because we can start adding and manipulating and adding all sorts of fun effects and things to these specific layers. By default, your layer is locked, and we can go ahead and unlock that by simply dragging this lock icon down to the trash can, and the layer is unlocked. We're going to go ahead and name this landscape and hit enter. Again, to name a layer, you just double click on the layer name. You can type the name that you wish and click away. All right, so once we have our layers named, we can go ahead and work with the different ways you'll navigate a layer in your workspace. So one of those ways is to zoom in and out of the image. If you hit Z on your keyboard, you're going to go to the zoom tool. The zoom tool, you'll notice on every single tool in your toolbar, you actually get a little icon for the hotkey. Now, once you have your zoom tool activated, you can simply hit your left mouse button and zoom in to whatever area of the image you want. If you want to zoom out, you can hold down your Alt key or your Option key if you're using a Mac. And when we zoom out of that image, you can see at the very bottom of the interface, it will tell us how much percent in and out we are going. To move your canvas around the screen, simply hold down the space bar and click on your left mouse button. This will give you access to the hand tool, which is one of your more commonly used tools in Adobe Photoshop. If you want to get back to your move tool, you can simply go to the move tool and click on it, or you can hit the V key to get back to your move tool. This move tool will allow you to actually click on a layer and move it. Now, in this case, we need to select our layer and then we can move it in space. If this layer was locked, like it was in the original file, we would not be able to move that. This background that you see just means this is transparent and there will be nothing there if you export. So again, be careful how you move your layers. One of the other important tools for Adobe Photoshop is your adjustments panel. We're going to be talking about this in later lessons, but in the adjustment panels, you can find different ways to non-destructively edit your image. Non-destructive essentially just means you can always go back to the starting point without having to undo too much. So your adjustments, if you go ahead and navigate and then scroll down in the panel, will add a layer on top of the layer stack. This layer now can manipulate things like the color or the saturation or the brightness or contrast of that image using the hue and saturation adjustment layer. If this is something you do not want, you can simply highlight that specific layer and click the trash can. That will delete it. If you want to go back in your image, you can hold Control Z, and the more times you hit Control Z, you'll go backwards. Now, if you're wondering all the changes that you made, you can always go to your window and you can navigate to the history panel. And the history panel, even if you've undone things, will show you all of those different layers, and you can go ahead and click and navigate between those different layer changes. All right, now that we've opened a file and I've shown you how to add a quick adjustment layer, let's go ahead and discuss how we're going to export this file. So to save our work, we can do a few different things. We can go to File, Save As, and in the Save As menu, we're going to be greeted with a way to save. Now, I'm going to go down here to Save As Type. Here, we have a few different options like PNG, PDF, JPEG, Photoshop file, you name it. Now, the PSD is the native format for Photoshop. This will save all your layers, all the adjustments, so you can come back and edit them later. If you want to just flatten your image, you can do Save As Copy. When you do Save As Copy, though it looks very similar, you can go ahead and you'll open the little dropdown and see you have a lot more images. So here we'll pick that JPEG option and we'll call this flattened image and we'll go ahead and hit save. That will bring up this toolbar where you can set your quality. I'm going to leave it by default, and that's going to give us a flattened image with no layers. All right, everybody, that is our first tutorial. There is no assignment associated with this tutorial. Go ahead and practice navigating around Photoshop and familiarize yourself with the interface. In our next video, we'll dive deeper into the tools and techniques that you can use to create stunning digital art. All right, everybody, hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you for the next one.